My brothers and sisters, we have been talking about the values that accompany the social teaching of the Catholic Church. And I wanted to review some of the values that we have in our faith, in our church, since we have the election coming up. And I think it is important for us to be reminded again of the values that we as a Catholic community in our society hold. Values that really come and have the source from our Lord Jesus Christ. And we know that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. In Jesus we find life and we find the truth. So that's why we have been talking about the seven core values of the social teaching of the Catholic Church. Last weekend we talked about life, and we were reminded how life is precious. Life is a gift from the Lord. Jesus Christ is life itself, and he even died for us on the cross in order to give us a new life, everlasting life. An everlasting life is not just simply a life without end, but a life in Christ. It's a holy life in Christ, a life full of the mercy and the love of our Lord Jesus Christ. And we were reminded how we are to love and respect life from the moment of conception to natural death. God is the owner even of our own life. Today, we talk about, after talking about the greatest value, the value of life, then today we talk about the value of family. Family is a value, and the Catholic Church protects and promotes the family life in the members of our Christian community. Family is the second value that we talk in the social teachings of the church. And notice, for example, in today's gospel, how Jesus comes to heal and to support some members of this family. This woman who was on his way out to the cemetery to bury her only son. And Jesus Christ comes to touch personally these members of the family. And we see how through his mercy and his compassion, he talked to the man, and the man then who was dead came back to life. And then I love when the gospel says, and then Jesus gave him to his mother. We see the Lord being part of our families. So today, we talk about the value of family. If we want to have a healthy and good and prosperous society, we want to have healthy and holy families. The family is the center of the society. And we know that a family begins with marriage. We know that marriage is the union between a man and a woman. It's a holy covenant. It's a union of love. It's a man and a woman who are committed to love one another in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, for the rest of their lives. They want to be loving one another. They want to have children and raise them together and give them the teachings that we know from Jesus Christ. Don't let anyone, even popular politicians, don't let anyone tell you that marriage is not the union between a man and a woman. That is wrong. And that's not really even natural. The relationship comes into, in marriage is a man and a woman. And we who are people of faith, even not only know that from nature, but also we know from faith that that union is between a man and a woman. And that's the way Jesus Christ, that's the way God himself, when we see that from the very beginning of Holy Scripture, in the book of Genesis, that's how God intended it to be. The union between a man and a woman. Man and female, he created them. The Holy Scripture says. Adam and Eve were that original couple, a man and a woman, the first husband and the first wife, united in love. So once we have a man and a woman dedicated and who have consecrated that love to the Lord in the church, in the sacrament of marriage, then from there we have a good and holy family. Spouses that love one another and respect one another, and children who come then to complement that love. And we promote that unity and that family in our Christian communities. It is in our families where we learn the basic themes of life, including our faith. It is in our families that we learn to trust. We learn to love. We learn to share. It is through our Father that we learn that God is a Heavenly Father. It is through our mother that we find and we learn the tenderness and the compassion of our Lord. But there's so many things that we can talk and say about a family. Today, I simply would like to approach the family from this perspective, which is a little unique, I will say, but I think it's important for us to keep in mind as Catholic families. There are so many things that are trying to destroy our families today, but one thing that is coming too strong to destroy our families, even our Catholic families, is the sin of anger. When we see spouses being angry at one another, and when we see parents being angry at their children, and when we see children being angry at one another, brother and sisters against each other. Anger is a sin, and it is coming to destroy that holy gift that the Lord has provided to us as a family. And we have to do something about it, we who are people of faith. And I invite you, as your priest, do not be angry. But what can we do? How does angry work? We know that angry never brings unity and peace. Angry, on the contrary, leads to separation, to division, to resentment, to revenge, and even in some cases, to murder. We don't want to go that way. We want to avoid being angry. Is it possible? Yes, it is possible. We know that when, if we can take, sometimes we have people saying that I have a short temper and I just simply get mad and angry so quickly, I don't even think about it. When I open my eyes, I'm already angry. But that's not true. That is not true. If we can see, for example, a man who gets angry so easily, and we can take it in a like a videotape it and then play it in a slow motion way, we can see that there are different steps that the person is going through. The first one is when the person is the button is being pushed like by someone or an event. So something is making him upset. Someone or something, an event, is making him uncomfortable and is bothering him. That's the first thing that he's experiencing. The second, he realizes that that is happening to him. So someone or something is pressing that button And then the second step is he realizes that button is being pressed. Then the third is the important one. Once he knows that that button is pressed, there is a window of choices. So he enter into a window of choices when he can choose how he's going to respond to that situation. And that's the important one. In this case, the fourth step is he's choosing to be angry. But he doesn't have to choose to be angry. He can choose something else. And that's my message to you today. When you enter into that window of choices, do not choose angry. Choose Christ. Choose Christ. And I can guarantee you, if you, instead of choosing angry, you choose Christ, you won't be angry. Your life will be different. You will see light in a situation when you thought was to just kill the other person. You will see hope. You will see that there is a solution to that situation and to that problem. That you can face that person who was pressing that button or that situation, you can approach it in a much better way, in a holy way. And that's my message to you. Again, the steps that we see is when someone or an event is making the person, is pressing that button, is upsetting the person. Then the person realizes, when you realize that someone is pressing that button that bothers you, you enter into a window of choices. Once you enter there, do not choose angry. Choose Christ. How? Through humility, through humor. You can choose something else and you can respond in another way. If you have the opportunity, just be quiet and say a prayer during that time. You say a prayer quietly and you will see that the Lord will come to assist you and to help you in that regard. No one is going to make you angry. No one makes you angry. People can press that button, yes, or a situation can press that button, but they're not making you angry. You are the one choosing to be angry. That's why I suggest to you, and I motivate you, do not choose to be angry. Choose Christ. It's better. It's much, much better. And is the holy way to do that. So anger is something that is attacking our families. And we see many people, members of the family, fighting with one another and not really taking care of one another and loving one another because they have allowed anger to play an important role in their relationships. It doesn't have to be that way. We who know Christ, we who love Christ, and we who serve Christ can do much, much better than that. We have been talking about the values that we have in the social teachings of the church. Since we have the election coming up, it's important for us to be reminded of the values that we have in our community, in the church. We talked about last weekend of the beautiful and the greatest of all, the value of life. And today we talk about the value of a family. A family is beautiful. It's a school when we learn beautiful things, including things from above, about God Himself. May the Lord protect your families, all our families. May the Lord help us to be in harmony with one another, to forgive one another, and to love one another. And we follow the relationship in our families is to follow the relationship of the Holy Trinity. May the Lord bless your family. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.